One of the most popular stock media websites is Motion Array. You've probably seen a lot of ads for it on YouTube and on social media, but is Motion Array worth it for your video projects? I've had the chance to review and kind of use a lot of the different video, audio, and graphics inside Motion Array, and I have to say it has a lot of strengths and weaknesses. And I think it really depends on the type of video projects that you work on. So in this video, I'm going to be reviewing Motion Array, kind of show you guys the pros and cons when using the stock media website. Now, just a quick disclaimer before we dive into today's video, Motion Array did provide me a free trial to review their product. Although this video isn't technically sponsored, I may receive a small commission if you use the link down in the video description. But otherwise, everything I'm saying in this video is my 100% honest review. So with that out of the way, let's dive in and see what Motion Array has to offer. Motion Array is membership-based. When you go to their website, you can navigate to their pricing tab to see the different plans they have. They have the monthly plan that costs $29 a month. And if you're looking to save, you can choose the annual plan that costs about $20 a month, but is billed annually. And they even have a team section starting at $37.50 a month. So what exactly is in their subscription? If you browse their website, there's templates, presets, audio files, video files, and a new image section, as well as plugins, tools, and actually a tutorial section. Now, one important note when it comes to their licensing structure is that you can download any asset, unlimited downloads, with an active subscription. But say if you actually cancel your subscription, you can't use any downloaded assets in future video projects. But don't worry, anything published and already out there, you don't have to really worry about. Now let's go into some of the top features. One of the best things about Motion Array is it actually comes with an extension for Premiere Pro. So from the Tools panel, you can actually click on Tools and go into Integrations, and then you can download an extension for Premiere Pro. And this is really nice. To access it, just go up to Window, Extensions, Motion Array. You'll have to log in, and once you do, you can actually search for stock video in the different categories in here. Easily just click the Downloads folder, and this saves a step into having to go to the website, click download, move it over. It's automatically right here inside Premiere Pro. So Motion Array is worth considering because not all stock websites have that type of extension. One of the other unique advantages to Motion Array is it actually comes with a video collaboration tool as well as a portfolio builder. So this is really aimed for freelancers that work with clients. Maybe you need a collaboration tool, very similar to Frame.io. And if you've seen my video, I'll link it right up there in case you want to check out Frame.io, but it's integration into Premiere Pro and After Effects where you can actually collaborate in real time with clients. But what Motion Array offers is something very similar, as well as a portfolio builder in case you need a landing page with some samples of your work. So those are the unique advantages. Now let's actually dive into the stock library. So first we'll go into templates, and you'll notice when you hover over something, you'll see the different programs that you can actually choose from. So I'm gonna go inside Premiere Pro. They have a lot of nice graphics for Premiere Pro. And I have to say Motion Array's strength is definitely in their graphics and different presets and templates. If you find yourself needing to use, you know, titles, transitions, logos, slideshows, or different graphics, Motion Array has you covered with a lot of different templates to choose from. And one of the advantages with Motion Array is that in the lower left-hand corner, you'll notice that there's a version section. So you can actually filter if you work in a certain version of Premiere Pro. This is very handy and very time-saving. Next, let's go under presets. Under presets, Premiere Pro, what I've noticed right off the bat here on the left is that they have a lot of good color and LUTs presets. So if you are into colorizing your footage a lot and giving it a unique look, you can get a lot of cool looking cinematic color looks inside Motion Array's pack. They have a LUTs section, which is very unique compared to a lot of other stock websites. Now, although these are pretty extreme type of LUTs like horror, it really comes down to the footage you work with and really depends on your project if you need these type of cinematic LUTs. So I recommend browsing the website for free first just to see if this may be something that you want to consider. I forgot to mention earlier, Motion Array actually does have a free section, so you can actually just sign up for free today and just try out some of the free templates that they have. Obviously, if you want to download something more premium, you have to actually upgrade to a plan, but you can set up just a free account and download some free basic assets to use in your video projects. The one drawback with templates and presets I notice is there's a lot of overlap between different sections. their actual filter section here, you know, their navigation on their website is just a little bit confusing. And to pinpoint, you know, you have templates, Premiere Pro, presets, Premiere Pro. Under videos, there's a motion graphics section. And then under templates, there's also another motion graphics section. So there's a lot of overlap, you'll notice. So it can be a little bit confusing trying to navigate the website sometimes. Next, let's go into audio. So under audio, you have two options here. You can click on royalty-free music and sound effects. Royalty-free music, you can search on the filters on the left for a BPM. If you need a certain duration, you can type it in there. Now, under the filters, they did something a little interesting. They actually combined the theme and the genre together. So you'll notice here, like they have, you know, a mood like peaceful, and then they have like a genre like metal right above it. And another note too that I noticed, like say if you check metal and you check peaceful, you're not actually gonna get metal music that's peaceful. It'll choose one or the other. So in this case, you know, if we play this song, it's obviously peaceful, it's not metal. So that's one drawback about the filters in Motion Array's music library, is that it doesn't actually filter down. It actually picks one or the other. It doesn't actually choose both that are in both categories. Now, if we go into sound effects, very similarly, there's a filter section that you can search for a specific, you know, category of sound effects. Now, one note, if the sound effect is short and you preview it inside Motion Array, you'll notice that they have a preview voice over the actual sound effect. And when I browse, you know, very short sound effects like this, it can be kind of difficult to preview it and actually hear how the sound effect sounds like with that preview voice over it. So that's just something to consider. Now, obviously, if you have a license, you can just download it, preview it that way, but it's just an extra step. Now let's go under video. Under videos, there's a footage and motion graphics section. We'll go into footage. Very similarly, there's a section to the left where you can filter. Now, what is cool about Motion Array is that you can actually sort by newest. So you can actually see the newest footage, stock footage, and different stock, even the music and other things as well. By newest, that way you're seeing what's brand new into Motion Array. So obviously these are all new clips that just got uploaded. But otherwise, other filters on the left, you can sort by resolution. You can sort by orientation. They even have vertical, which is nice. You can sort by frame rate as well. So if you know you shoot in a certain frame rate, you can change it. And also just a quick note, at the very bottom, there's free assets as well. So once free is checked, you can actually download free assets. And you'll notice that there's a little free mark next to the video footage. Now, one of the downsides about Motion Array stock footage is that you're kind of stuck with whatever it was shot in. For example, you can't download like an HD version of a maybe Apple Pro as 422 4K file. Say if we click on this clip here, you'll notice that it's ProRes 422 at 4K. And when you click download, you don't have an option to download HD or maybe a different codec. So that's just something to consider if you're thinking about Motion Array for stock footage. Now the other section is motion graphics. And one note, like I was saying earlier, it's a little bit confusing, but like, for example, if you click on lower thirds, what these aren't Mogurts or Premiere Pro templates. These are actually graphics that you can overlay on your footage that are pre-rendered, already rendered out. So that's essentially what motion graphics are under the videos tab. Now, one note about backgrounds that I don't really care for that much is that under the filter section, there's a lot of good filters, but they're missing one thing that I like, and that's a looped section. For example, if you want to download a background, you know, for a video project, maybe you want it to have it loop. So, you know, if this is only 30 seconds long and you need a graphic background that's over a minute, you'll have to make it loop somehow if it doesn't already. Now, one good thing about this is that there's a framing devices section. This is very handy if you work with logos or maybe you need a background slate and you want to put something over it. You can easily like download this one, for example, put someone's logo in the middle or some text. This is really nice for framing, you know, a background around graphics. This is very unique to Motion Array. I haven't really seen this on any other website outside of Motion Array. So that's motion graphics. Now let's go into the new images section. Under images, there's graphics and photos. We'll go into graphics. One of my favorite features inside graphics is that you can actually sort by the file type. So say, for example, as a video editor, I always want PNG files that I can put over things. You know, a lot of the other stock websites such as, you know, Shutterstock maybe, you know, you get EPS file or a vector file, and maybe you just want something simpler like a PNG file to put over your video projects. So that's one of my favorite features under images. Under photos, very similar to all the other options. You have filters to the left where you can choose from a certain category. There's even a free section. Like I said earlier, you can make a free account today if you're interested. Now let's go under plugins. You'll notice that there's an Ultimate Premiere Pro plugin toolkit, so you can automatically download this and it will be installed in Premiere Pro. And just to show you how that looks, if you go inside Premiere Pro, you'll want to navigate to your effects panel. Under video effects, you'll notice that there's a motion array folder. So if you untwirl that, you get some effects in here that you can add to your video clips. And then if you go under video transitions, there's a MA and then the name of the effect that you're applying here. So for example, I have two clips from Motion Array, and I added this slicer bounce effect in between, you know, the clips here. What is nice about Motion Array's transitions is that they're baked in as like normal transitions here, where a lot of other transition packs actually have nested clips on top of your clips. So using Motion Array's transitions saves on timeline real estate. So with that, that pretty much wraps up my review for Motion Array. At the end of the day, I really think Motion Array is really great for video editors or content creators that need a lot of graphics and things to really spice up your video projects. There's a lot of great graphics, color effects, and different things that you can really add to your project. And I also think it's really great for freelancers that really want to build out, you know, a landing page for their work, you know, such as the portfolio builder, or also integrating the collaboration tools that Motion Array also offers. So that's my thoughts. Let me know what you think of Motion Array down in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.